Alright, let's continue. I'm going to generate the search tags for the chart of accounts. It's going to be equal to general ledger account code, and I just add a few space in between. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's totally okay, it's just cosmetic. Usually I'll leave some space so that I just make the later stage tag slicing much easier. After the space, I just alt enter and then index. I'm going to look up from the chart of account. This is the chart of account. And you see it's all highlighted in red. Okay, comma, alt enter, and again, this is the row match, column match, alt enter, and close bracket. Let me make it a little bit bigger. So the row match is going to be, okay, I just add two more comma, and the first attribute is the lookup value. The lookup value is going to be individual general ledger account code. And the lookup array is that I'm going to look up from the whole general ledger account code column. So I just get rid of this at sign. The match type is going to be 0, exact match. And the match type, again, I'm going to add two more comma here. The lookup value is just the language choice number, which is in the bookkeeping interface, the language that we just select. And I'm going to look up from, because I have to look up these three or more language descriptions, right? So I'm going to select the whole column head, which is in green, all right? And then the match type is going to be 0. Okay, so you have this in return. For tax code, I'll do this when I create a tax schedule in later stage. Basically, what it does is just grouping. For example, like 1000 and 1000.1, they should be grouped in 1000 in the tax schedule in Canada. But I'm going to write the formula later. Okay, let's take a break. I'm going to create three more columns. They are B, the interbank transfer account, P, purchase related accounts, and R, the revenue related accounts. Let's say in our transaction item, let's say if I choose the transaction type P, I want to select only from the accounts that are related to purchase. If I change it to revenue, I want to select only those accounts that are related to revenue. Okay, let's go back to our chart of account. I just called it RPGL accounts. Okay, RPGL accounts, and I'm going to make it white because it is generated by formula. So it shouldn't be green. Save it. And I'm going to create similar one, which is called the ORGL accounts and ORB. Bank accounts, interbank accounts, okay? So let me just copy that and make it all white. You notice there is one category called A. A very good example is the accounts receivable. Because in the bookkeeping interface, you're not going to deal with the double entry. So you're not going to touch the accounts receivable, accounts payable, tax payable, that sort of things. So it should be restricted to only those expense or income accounts or cash accounts. And for this one, I'm not going to create a field for these items because it's at the back of the system, so it's not going to be displayed. So I don't bother create the Chinese, Japanese, and English descriptions for that. So this one is going to be equal to, this formula is quite complicated. Let me explain it a little bit first. We are going to list all the accounts that the process type equals P, which is a purchase, right? So it's going to be like this. And I'm going to use the index to look up for the blue column, which is the search general account code text, the one that we just create. And we use the aggregate function to rank those accounts. So I'm going to redo it so that you can follow the logic. So let's go to the ORPGL accounts, and we use the index to look up for the search GL account codex, that is the list of all the GL accounts, and I get rid of the at sign so that you can select the whole column right? So this is our result. And then we put the comma and alt enter. And I'm going to use the aggregate and I'm going to use the first attribute small, 15. So I put 15 comma and the second attribute is 6 because we are going to ignore any errors that arise when the process type is not what we are looking for here. So it's 6 and then comma. And here I just put a bracket first because we are going to fill in the row over part. I just call it row over part divided by the criteria. And I'm going to fill that in later, okay? Comma, I'm going to put K. You see K. K is just a counter that counts from the top to bottom. So we're going to use the rows formula of J8 because the first row of the OPGL account column is J8. And we press F4 to lock it. Then colon, and I put J8 again. So that when I scroll down the column, it becomes J9, J10, something like that, okay? Since it is the first row, so I put J8, and then I close the bracket for rows for K, and then I close the bracket for aggregate, and then I press Alt-Enter, and close the bracket for index. So let me do this part again. So it's going to be the row of the whole column. So the row of, so I just put the row first. So this is the row, and then minus the row of the first cell, which is J8. Okay, so let me just, it doesn't matter because I can just put J8 and then lock it and then press 1. And then I divide this one by the criteria, which is the process type. I just get rid of the at sign and select the whole column of the process type and it's equals to text string P. So this time it should work, yeah. So it's very tricky. So you see all the accounts are listed here. So it's in ascending order. We can just Ctrl C, Ctrl V to copy that for the revenue. The only part that we need to change, instead of the OP1, we choose the OR, the revenue accounts. Instead of J8, we should select K8 because column K8 is the first cell of the OR column, right? And the GL account process type should be capital R. Then we have all the revenue accounts that are available for us to include in the drop-down list. Okay, and we move on to the bank, which is this one. Again, we just change a little bit on the formula. Instead of R, include B because this is the column here, right? Instead of K8, I'm going to do L8. This is L8 cell, which is the first cell of the OB column, okay? Instead of R, I'm looking for the process type B, which we defined earlier before. Oh, actually, you need to change row as well, but that's okay. Even if we still get the result because the K is just rolling from the top. Oh, but usually, I will change that as well. I think it looks a little bit more systematic to me. So instead of J8, this one for revenue, I change it to K8. Okay, so this one is perfectly fine. So just take a break first.